Good day to all of you. In this video, I am going to talk about the role of hormones and autoids in the control of glomerular filtration rate. So this is the efferent and the efferent arteriole and the Bowman's capsule. I am going to talk about four agents: the sympathetic nervous system, angiotensin II, prostaglandins, and nitric oxide. First, we'll talk about the division of the autonomic nervous system called the sympathetic nervous system. This division, sympathetic nervous system, sympathy, because tachycardia occurs in response to sympathy to injury, because when we have sympathy for somebody's injury, there is tachycardia. So this is known as sympathetic nervous system. It is mediated by the sympathetic nervous system, so it is called a sympathetic nervous system. With regards to the sympathetic nervous system, it releases the hormone norepinephrine, mainly from the sympathetic nerve endings, and from the adrenal medulla, epinephrine is released. Norepinephrine acts on alpha-1 adrenoreceptors, and by causing vasoconstriction and by decreasing the diameter of the efferent arteriole, it decreases the GFR. So there are two types of activation of the sympathetic nervous system: mild to moderate and severe. When does mild to moderate activation occur? Mild to moderate activation occurs during standing from a sitting position. If I stand from the chair I am sitting on currently, then there is mild to moderate activation. And please remember, mild to moderate activation has little or no change in GFR. Mild to moderate activation produces little or no change in GFR. But if the activation is severe activation occurs when a large amount of blood is lost, as for example, in a road traffic accident. Then it causes strong activation of the sympathetic nervous system. And this reduces the GFR. So mild to moderate activation of the sympathetic nervous system, as for example, standing from a sitting position, produces no change in GFR, while strong activation as occurs after hemorrhage, which may occur after a road traffic accident, produces a reduction in GFR. The mild to moderate activation is buffered by agents known as prostaglandins. So now I am going to talk about these agents, the prostaglandins. PGs, which are very vital in our life because they have renoprotective effect. When mild to moderate activation of the sympathetic nervous system occurs during standing, there might be renal ischemia, but this renal ischemia is prevented by prostaglandins. Prostaglandins prevent the renal ischemia resulting from mild to moderate activation of the sympathetic nervous system. And thereby protect the kidneys. Prevent renal ischemia when there is mild to moderate activation of the sympathetic nervous system, as for example during standing, and thereby protect the kidneys. These prostaglandins are inhibited by a class of drugs called NSAIDs. NSAID stands for non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, and these may be brufen, paracetamol, so chronic ingestion of NSAIDs will inhibit the prostaglandins, and as a result there will be renal ischemia during mild to moderate sympathetic activation, and that will cause renal failure. Nitric oxide produces vasodilation, it dilates the efferent arteriole and increases the GFR. The fourth agent is angiotensin 2. Angiotensin 2 has a preferential constricting effect on the efferent arterioles and not on the afferent arterioles. Please remember, angiotensin 2 constricts the efferent arterioles. This angiotensin 2 mediated constriction might be mild to moderate or severe constriction. When it is mild, when the efferent arteriole is just constricted, then what happens is that the back pressure, the backflow of fluid increases the glomerular capillary hydrostatic pressure, which is the main driving force for GFR, and that increases the GFR. While if the constriction is severe, that is it, if it is greater than 3 times, that is, it is greater than 3 times, then it increases the glomerular colloid osmotic pressure, and this results in decrease in GFR. So, sympathetic nervous system, prostaglandins, nitric oxide, and angiotensin 2. Mild to moderate sympathetic activation during standing has no effect on GFR, while severe activation during hemorrhage reduces GFR. Mild to moderate activation is buffered by prostaglandins, which prevent renal ischemia due to mild to moderate activation of the sympathetic nervous system and protect the kidneys. These prostaglandins are inhibited by NSAIDs, and chronic ingestion of NSAIDs can cause renal failure. Nitric oxide causes vasodilation. Angiotensin 2 constricts the efferent arterioles, and if there is mild constriction, it increases the glomerular capillary hydrostatic pressure and increases GFR. And severe constriction, it increases the colloid osmotic pressure and decreases GFR. Thank you for watching my video, and have a good day.